Hi guys, Aris, Hardware with Busters International. Corsair's HX1500i line got stronger with a 1500 watt PSU, which uses a semi-digital CWT platform, offering tons of power and high performance. Now, with $400 price tag, this is among the most expensive power supplies on today's market, and one of the few ones also that are supported by software, iCUE, in this occasion, for monitoring and controlling of some vital functions. Through iCUE, you can select single rail or multi-rail mode, control the fan speed, and monitor the PSU's performance. I'm not a big fan of iCUE, mainly because it is a bit complicated, since it supports a wide range of Corsair products, but the fact is that it offers lots of options. You need to get used to this software to use it efficiently. Speaking of efficiency, it is Cybernetics Platinum rated, and it also has a Platinum rating by 80+. In noise, Cybernetics A-, meaning 25 to 30 dBA average noise output, but you can make your own fan speed profile through iCUE, so this can change. Dimensions, large with 200 mm depth. Power specifications, single 12-volt rail or multiple 12-volt rails if you select this option through iCUE. Power distribution, 1500 watt at 12-volt and 150 watt maximum power on the minor rails combined. Cables, 3PS connectors on 3 cables, 9 PCI Express connectors, 6 plus 2 pins on 6 cables, 16 SATA connectors on 4 cables, 8 4-pin Molex connectors on 2 cables. All cables are long enough, but typically for Corsair PSU, the distance between the peripheral connectors is shorter than 150 mm. There are no in-cable caps, which is good, and there are no PCI Express 5 connectors, which is not that good. But Corsair provides corresponding cables, so you can get them from Corsair's site, store, should you need them. Each one costs $20. Yeah, they are not cheap, but I guess they are of good quality, high quality. And 600 watt connectors and cables, all of them. As far as I know, most brands prefer to provide 600 watt PCI Express 5 cables and connectors to not have any confusion or problems in their portfolio of products. This is not the best thing for some PSUs, especially low capacity ones, but this specific unit won't have a problem handling 600 watt PCI Express 5 connectors. Okay, let's continue. Internal design. The build quality is high and quality parts were used, including Infineon and VSA FETs, along with Texas Instruments controllers. That's also a microchip MCU. The platform is modern and semi-digital, meaning that the digital controllers handle the entire primary side and a part of the secondary side. The only circuits that use analog controllers are the VRMs for the minor rails and the 5SB circuit. Soldering quality is not up to Flextronics or Delta levels, but still, it is pretty good. The 140mm cooling fan uses a fluid dynamic bearing and it is of high quality. Protection features. Overcurrent protection is conservatively set at 12V and the same goes for overpower protection. On the contrary, OCP is set high on the minor rails. The rest protection features are present and working as they should do. Load regulation. I expected a tighter load regulation at 12V. Ripple suppression is low on all rails without the use of extra in-cable caps, which make cable routing and management daunting tasks. Transient response is within 1% at 12V, which is good, but the competition fares better here. The hold-up time is long enough and the power key signal is accurate. The PSU supports alternative low power modes, which the ATX3 spec requires. Inrush current is low with 115 volt input, but pretty high with 230 volt. Efficiency at normal light and super light loads. The HX1500i is efficient with normal and ultra light loads, but I would like to see a bit higher efficiency in the 20 up to 80 watt load range. The 5SB rail is highly efficient. Vampire power is dead low. The average efficiency is at the proper levels for a platinum rated unit. The APFC converter needs tuning to deliver higher PF readings with 230 volt input. The average fan noise is kept low. Let's take a look at the fan noise and speed maps at normal temperatures, 28 to 32 degrees Celsius. The load on the minor rails affects overall noise output, but on the other hand, this unit has powerful minor rails, so most likely you will never have to push them at the max. Up to around 860 watt load, noise is inaudible. You will have to reach 1000 watt for noise to exceed 30 dBA. With more than 1200 watt, you enter the 35 dBA zone. Overall performance is good, but I would like to see the HX1500i closer to the Tough Power TF1 with 1550 watt capacity. The latter is titanium rated, but it costs less than the HX1500i. Bottom line, the HX1500i has top build quality and will cope with heavy abuse without sweating. This is a power supply for demanding gaming systems. The digital interface and the ability to control and monitor the PSU through iCUE software is an interesting feature. Okay, I have to admit that I'm not a big fan of iCUE since I find it challenging to use, but the fact is that it provides lots of options. And this is the problem, too many options, so many things can go south quickly. I expected a higher performance from the HX1500i. Another issue is the lack of PCI Express 5 connectors, but I guess like many brands, Corsair will soon update this PSU offering these connectors from the factory, and for you can actually buy now extra PCI Express 5 connectors should you need them, about $20 each from Corsair's site. I'm not going to go into the pros and cons of this product. You can read our full review at awbusters.com along with more charts and more details about this PSU. It will be nice to support our effort on this side. We do so much hard work there and in the YouTube channels, of course. Please subscribe to our channel and enable the notifications to be among the first to watch our videos. We also have a Patreon page if you want to support us. Until the next video, bye bye.